right, just finished dinner here. Let's see if I can do well in Google Kickstart Round B. Round is loading. Okay, let's open up this problem. Oh, okay. So it decreases pretty fast. Sum of areas of all circles. Okay, so this is a stupid simulation problem. Start with R times A. Okay, I should have made these long ones because it could overflow. You need to draw the left, okay. Where's the pi constant defined? I'll just use a tan negative 1. That works, right? I guess that works. I can multiply that in the end. Have an area. Well, R is not 0. We add the area and then we update R based on the rule. For this, we divide by b, but first we multiply by a. And it's negative, which is obviously not correct. Did I do it? Okay, maybe this will work better. Yeah, I'm done. I forgot how A10 works. Looks good. Submit this and hope it actually works. This is a bit slow for an A. Factors of A, which are 10 to the 10. Okay, so this is stupid because there are only like square root n factors or something. So we have our list of factors. Times I is less than or equal to A, and then we add 1 to I. Okay, it passed. That's cool. If E mod I is equal to 0, then we'll add I as a factor and if I times I is less than a, also add a divided by I. Now we just need to test each factor. Each factor f, let's find the string so that's easier to work with. We just test if it's a palindrome. And also let's just test it. How do I make sure this, I think, okay, size will always be positive, so this will always be good. Okay, let's try this. 4376 should be the correct output. Okay, to total answer, which I forgot to do. Six, this worked. Submit and moved on to the third problem, which has three parts. Okay, so that was mod D. So n is less than or equal to d, or what does this mean? Oh, okay, close to right. Beginning range. Okay. Cool, this passed. Oh, it must be contained. It's downward. And then, okay. Minimum number of valid operations. What's n? Okay, n is small, so this is just a DP problem. Yeah, this is a DP problem. DP on ranges should be fairly straightforward. So we start out with n and d, I guess. Okay. What's our DP? This is a minimum number of operations starting from like a certain place. So n is less than or equal to 400. Let's see. We also read the entire vector. J of J will just be equal to the minimum of V of I, V of J, and D minus V of J. Because you can rotate it both ways. Yeah, that makes sense. And then I iterate over I. Oh shoot, wait. No, this should be I. For, to make it easier to understand, I will be the left side of the range. Okay. So I need to calculate dpij is equal to, wait, did not handle a case where, yeah, I forgot about the transition case. Okay, let me think about this a bit more. It's probably some, yeah, the third dimension. And I guess it does make sense. Yeah, the third dimension representing where it has been turned to. But then, okay, yeah, I'm adding the third dimension because I think that's the way to go. Wait, actually, ranges don't split, they only like decrease in size and they contain each other. So you just want to satisfy the left or the right. Okay, this DP still makes sense. K will be equal to, plus V of K mod D, and then D minus this thing as well. It should be minus, actually. Plus D minus whatever. Actually, there are two ways. No, you always. Yeah, anyway, you add this. Yeah. Actually, after you turn. It will always be equal to left or right, right? So I actually don't see why this is needed, but why you need n cubed, but it maybe could be optimized, but for our purposes, n cubed is enough. 100 times, yeah. Now we need to calculate dpijk. So, Doesn't he make it so it merges with the neighbors, right? Okay, whatever. Can you actually define what this means? This means so far we've turned this amount. Okay. Let me loop through K. Here we make j equal to 0. Yeah, and then we add however much it takes. V of j plus d minus v of k, and then d minus that. That's one transition. Yeah, as I was saying, J can, this third one can only take on two values, really. So, this is kind of unnecessarily slow, but the constraints do allow it. Unless there's something wrong with my solution, in which case, that would be sad. Forgot the case, the initial case. It's okay, I just choose the minimum of. Do I? Something. That something is V n minus 1 DP 0 n minus 1 0 Z 0 plus D minus Z 0. Okay, that's a bit of code. I'm actually not sure if this is 3 and 5. So I did not like the last one. Wait a second, it's moving. Should be minus, right? Wait, it is minus, okay. So this is getting the distance. Yeah. I need to mend these too. I just said it without taking them in. That was dumb. Okay, so now I got D3. This one is a bit more annoying, so not sure it'll pass, but you can try. Last problem. All four cells are empty, or all four cells are occupied. Visit all cells. This is a funny problem. I think you find an older tour actually. What's the output? There's no solution, print impossible. Otherwise, print the sequence. Cool, the past. There's a tour where you go to and revisit edges twice. Wait, no, you just DFS, right? This literally looks like DFS. DFS, but you just don't visit same blocks twice. Okay, so how do I implement this? In DFS, I enter, don't visit again, so I have to go back from here. So I assume by the time I call, or no, I won't assume. Set NS. Okay, that makes sense actually. Let me implement this real quick. What is this? Is it guaranteed that first character? Okay, it's always that. Okay, first character is always open. Our grid. Read N and M. G. We'll resize that and then we'll read G. Problem is, I don't know where I enter. So I have to give it in the function. I also have to make sure everything is visited. So there's some cell that's still this. I print impossible. So here I do a DFS and then 4 or whatever. If it has not been visited, then it's impossible that I just return. Create something like this. There's we're at 0-0. Let's try to go north first. If we're at 0-1, let's try to go east. Southwest, okay. How to define the array. South is this, and then west is this. RJ, okay. Effectively, I2, which is the coordinates within the 2x2 block. Based on that, calculate k, which is 2 times i2 plus j2. That'll give us which direction we should try going in. Just create this function called canGo. Maybe make sure that the coordinates are correct. This is an M. And it has not been visited. GIJ. Here, first thing, GI2, I divide by 2, J divide by 2 is equal to, we'll mark it as visited, and then we want to iterate through k. We can actually create k as equal to k, and then at the end of the loop we increment the current k, and then after incrementing it's equal to k. Actually, this is just a do while loop. And afterward, we can just return. You have to add in north in the end. Otherwise, it looks good. New I is equal to I plus there's 2 CK. New J is J plus there's 2 CK. Now we can go there, then basically DFS there. And then we also need actors, CK. EFS NINJ. Okay. Otherwise, we need to move ourselves up in the next direction, which is this. Do you ever pop back to answer? What if you, does it always go like clockwise? He always entering in from here then. Yeah, okay. The first one you move here. CK turns into one, two, three. Zero. Okay, so the last one. I guess I need to pop back the last one. Otherwise, we'll revisit the same one twice. Unqualified. Oh, what does that mean? I'll just remove the constant. I think it should work. Was that error? Oh, I need to add 0 and 1 here. Okay, so it says everything is impossible, which is cap. So, I don't even know what happened. Oh yeah, I need to add. Can I move it here? I need to add 2i. Also need to add 2j as well. Otherwise it won't move to the other side. ESSS. ESS. Wait, what? East, south, south. West. Oh, okay, that works. But this does not. See, they don't know why the third one does not. Third one is good, right? Yeah. We just try it as a singular test case, and it fails. Let me just debug or put some debugging output. Zero two three, four three. So it goes to 02, 23, 43, 44, goes all the way to 36. I'm stupid. Hold off. The mapping is incorrect. I2 is 1, then 2 plus J2. No, 4 minus. 3 minus J2. Think this mapping works. How are the last two impossible? Okay, I guess I'm debugging again. Zero zero, zero two. Then it just decides to quit for some reason. Goes here to one. It comes down for two, we should. Is this messing up? I think this is correct. Wait, in both cases, I did not update INJ. Think that's what needs to happen. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. I'll submit this. 40 minutes. I mean, if this passes, then that's okay. You know, let's check the scoreboard. Last one is a bit hard. Two people have solved it. And this is still running. So I have no clue if. Why is it taking so long? What's the time limit? It actually should not be taking this long. As far as I know, these are like constant time. Yeah, constant time operations. Constant time, constant time. Should it? Oh, it passed. Okay, so am I the third person to solve it? Guess I am. And I also guess that I've won the round miraculously. Okay, this wasn't too bad. Yeah, hope to do this again in future rounds as well. And hope that everybody has good luck with Kickstart as well, or any other programming competition.